I can't believe how quickly the agent learned to predict fires. We need to hurry on this location at risk of fire. Let me know when you're ready to go. Fire can strike at any moment. If you would like to, that'd be great. All right, guys, we are actually going to unmute everybody in the chat so we can talk and go over this together. And if you guys have any questions, you can just ask them. All right, so I believe everybody is unmuted now.
Yeah.
Yep.
Do you guys enjoy this lesson?
Yeah.
I just got a message. Hold on, let me move this Zoom box. I just got a message from the command center. There's a storm rolling in with a high chance of lightning. We'll need to start clearing this area of dry brush before it gets here. Have the agent clear the line of dry brush to remove a fire risk. Okay, so we can see again. All right, guys, we got to save the village. Program our agent to destroy fire hazards in a row. Click the play button to run our coding game. So this loop, what exactly is this loop checking for? Can somebody tell me what this loop is checking for?
If hazards remain.
Okay, that's awesome because that's exactly what we need to do. So we're going to keep running this code as long as hazards remain. This if check, right? So we're going to be checking for what? What exactly are we looking for?
Dry brush.
Awesome. So do you understand the code structure of this? Agent destroy. So we destroyed the first one, but we forgot to add something in the code, didn't we? Do any of you guys?
Shouldn't we remove all the dry grass, like just like, you know, the punching it, like with the we usually do the punching.
We could, but we're doing this activity like this so we can learn some basic code structure and start thinking about how we could code things for good reasons. So we could we can't go down there in this version of Minecraft because we're blocked. But when we load up Minecraft, the actual Minecraft in a little bit, we can go down there and do it. But we're doing it this way so we can use the robot here that we're programming to help us get bigger tasks accomplished.
Can you ask him to dig?
Ask him to dig?
Yeah, like punch all the dry grass till there's only dirt or something?
Possibly. Can you tell me what's wrong with this code that we have here? So
are we supposed to get everything like green grass when... Is there any green grass code in there?
Well, not in this one. The green grass will grow on its own because as long as the dirt is taken care of, the grass transfers. Okay, looks like we're destroying all the grass here in the line. Oh, wow. There's the storm they were talking about. Oh no, guys, it's an actual fire now.
Do something, your robot will die.
How? That was close. Okay, let's see if we can plant some flowers like you said. Okay. Plant new crops and spawn some animals in the area. So how do you think we could do that? So on start, What do we need to do?
Maybe spawn the animal.
Spawn the animal. Okay, where do we want to spawn it?
Maybe where you walk.
Okay, so let's take this line out and, oh, well, I guess we can't. We'll do it like this. On player walk.
Mm-hmm.
Let's actually take a quick look and see. Okay, guys, so we could do it this way. On player walk, spawn animal. Is chickens okay with everybody?
Yeah.
So we're spawning chickens at...
They give out high eggs.
Yeah, they do.
Is that a grass patch?
Whoa. F11, is it?
Hi there, I'll name you Chuckles.
So when we walk, now we spawn chickens. That's cool.
Be sure to join TechDev Academy's workshops and camps and also read some great articles on their blog page.